Okay. It's a little bit behind, but I'm okay with that. All right. Okay. I just gotta make sure that I can't hear the thing.
Thank you. Thank you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you. We have come rejoicing into the house of the Lord for this celebration, dear brothers and sisters, and now we stand with Peter and Marianne on the day they intend to form a home of their own. For them, this is a moment of unique importance. So let us support them with our affection, with our friendship, and with our prayer for their brothers and sisters. Let us listen attentively with them to the word that God speaks to us today. Then with the Holy Church, let us humbly pray to God, Father, through Christ our Lord, for this covenant, his servants, that he lovingly accept them, bless them, and make them always one. Pomolimo se. Gospodine, obdario je zaručnike svoje milosti. Oni se pred oltarom združuju u ženi, utvrdi u uzajanjoj ljubavi. O Gospodin našemu Isusu Hristu, Sinu Bome, koji s tobom živi i hranje, u jedinstvu Duha Svetoga Boga, od sve vijeke vjekove. Please be seated now, as we hear the word of God.
Pitanje poslanice svetoga Ivana Apostola. Ljubljeni, ljubimo jedni i druge, jer ljubav je od Boga. I svaki koji ljubi, od Boga je rođen i poznaje Boga. Ko ne ljubi, ne pozna Boga, jer Bog je ljubav. U ovom se očitava ljubav Božja u nama. Bog, Sina svoga jednorođenoga, poslao u svijet, da živimo po njemu. U ovom je ljubav, ne da smo mi ljubili Boga, nego On je ljubio nas i poslao Sina svoga, kao pomirnicu za grijehe naše. Ljubljeni, ako je Bog tako ljubio nas, mi smo dužni ljubiti jedni druge. Boga nitko nikada ne ljubi. Ako ljubimo jedni druge, Bog ostaje u nama i ljubav je njegova u nama savršena. Riječ Gospodja.
Thank you.
letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. Brothers and sisters, as God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, meekness, and patience. Bear with one another, and if anyone has a complaint against another, forgive each other. Just as the Lord has forgiven you, so you must also forgive. Above all, clothe yourselves with love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony. And let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, to which indeed you were called in the one body. And be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly. Teach and admonish one another in all wisdom, and with gratitude in your hearts, sing psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs to God. And whatever you do, in word or deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. The word of the Lord.
As the Father has loved me, so I have loved you. Abide in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. I have said these things to you, so that my joy may be in you, and that your joy may be complete. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. The Gospel of the Lord. Please be seated. My dear friends, Peter and Marianne, first of all, I would like to commend you for making this decision to get married in church now, during this strange time of COVID-19 situation, which has affected the whole world, and you have not responded for next year, as many already did. Our daily routines have changed significantly in our homes and around us everywhere. This is a time when we have experienced and learned what is really important and what is less important in life. The two of you, Peter and Marianne, have recognized that being married in church, living the sacrament of marriage, is far more important than all those festivities that are part of a wedding ceremony and celebration. Wedding celebration with guests and friends is important, but not as important as living your Catholic faith in a sacramental way when you are blessed and accepted by God in the sacrament of marriage. And that's why I would like to commend you for making that decision at this time. Certainly, God will provide for you moments and events for your various celebrations in the future, and that's what we will pray for today. In every sacrament, my brothers and sisters, we celebrate, we are celebrating and honoring God who revealed himself to us as one God, but in three persons, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And that's how we start every Mass. And whenever we pray, we make a sign of the cross and say these words. This is a mystery which we will be able to comprehend only when we come to heaven. And coming to heaven is the final goal of our life, the main purpose in life one can have. All other goals, regardless how important they are in our lives, are just temporary goals, and they perish as soon as we reach them. But being together with God forever, for all eternity, is much more than we can imagine. When we are helping each other to stay united with God, we do the most one person can do. So dear Peter and Marianne, when you live for each other, when you help each other, when you serve each other, you are doing exactly what God wants us to do. The words of your commitment which you will pronounce to each other today have that meaning Christ wanted them to be embedded and lived daily. I love you and honor you in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health, all the days of my life. And when you commit yourselves to give yourselves to each other, you are also committing yourselves to God, who in return will bless you and approve your commitment. Your words of promises express trust and hope for the future. When we know that we are not alone on our way, that our future is not only in our hands, and that we will be assisted by God and the people who pray for us, that gives us confidence and peace of heart. After his resurrection, Jesus appeared many times to his disciples, and he said to them many times, "Do not be afraid. I am with you always." And these same words are intended to resound in our heads at all moments in our life, when we are celebrating life and success, or when we mourn and feel overcome by difficulties of life. Do not be afraid. My dear friends, Peter and Marianne, live your faith every day. Pray together every day. Go to church together on Sundays. Be open to God, be charitable, and you will definitely experience the presence of God in your own lives and in your home. May the good Lord bless you and give you his peace and all good. The rest of you please remain seated, but Marianne and Peter rise so that we can see them a little bit better and hear better what they will say to each other. Dearly beloved, you have come together into the house of the church, so that in the presence of the church minister and the community, your intention to enter into marriage may be strengthened by the Lord with the sacred seal. Christ abundantly blesses the love that binds you. Through a special sacrament, he enriches and strengthens those he has already consecrated by holy baptism, that they may be faithful to each other forever, and assume all the responsibilities of every life. And so, in the presence of the Church, I ask you to state your intentions. Peter and Mary, having come here to enter in marriage without coercion, freely and wholeheartedly. Are you prepared, as you follow the path of marriage, to love and honor each other for as long as you both shall live?
Yes.
Are you prepared to accept children lovingly from God and to bring them up according to the law of Christ and His Church?
Yes.
Since it's your intention to enter into the covenant of holy matrimony, face each other, hold your hands, and declare your consent before God and His Church.
I, Peter,
take you, Marianne, to be my wife. I promise to be faithful to you in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health, to love you and to honor you all the days of my life. I, Miriam, take you, Peter, to be my husband. I promise to be faithful to you in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health, to love you and to honor you all the days of my life. May the Lord in His kindness strengthen you the saints you have declared before the Church, and graciously bring you fulfillment with blessings within you. What God joins together, let no one put aside. The best man, the maid of honor, please come forward. May the Lord bless these rings which you will give to each other as a sign of your love and fidelity. Marianne received this ring as a sign of your love,
sign of my love
and fidelity. In the name of the Father,
in the name of the Father,
and of the Son,
and of the Son,
and of the Holy Spirit. Peter, receive this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. So please rise now, the best man and the maid of honor, to go to their places. And now we pray for this new family. Renewed by the love of God, reflected in the love of Peter and Marianne, we confidently pray for all in need. Our response to the petitions will be, Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who bear the name of Christian, may we be faithful in giving witness to God's love. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the leaders of the world, may they be committed to the welfare of every person. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Marianne and Peter, united in marriage today, may their love for God and each other grow stronger every day. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all married people, may their love and passion be constant source of hope in our world. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are in need of food, shelter, and clothing, may they come to possess the necessities of life. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick members of Christ's body, May they find healing and strength in our Savior, Jesus Christ. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our deceased brothers and sisters, may they live forever in the kingdom of God, prepared for them by our Lord Jesus. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. Let us pause for a moment and say a prayer for this new family. Potešeni, recimo svoju osobnu molitvu za novu obitelj. Gracious and loving God, we ask you to look with favor on our friends. Grant them in your goodness, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated. Molite, braće i sestre, da moja i vaša žrtva bude ugodna Bogu Ocu svemogućem. Gospodine, prinosimo ti ove darove, da očinskom dobrotom čuvaš ove mladence koje su družio svetom ženinom. Po Kristu, Gospodinu našem. Gospodin s vama, gore srca, hvala dajmo Gospodinu Bogu našemu. U istinu je dostojno i pravedno, pravo i spasonosno, da vas da i svake zahvaljujemo tebi, Gospodine, sveti Otče svemogući i vječni Bogu, po Kristu našem Gospodinu. Ti si sklopio novi savez sa svojim narodom, u tajni Kristove smrti i uskrsnuća, da čovjeka učini dionikom božanske naravi i baštenikom nebeske slave. Znam toga savjeza je zbračna veza muža i žene. Zato je ovo ženitveno slavlje, potajstvo tvoje ljubavi i savjezničke vijenosti. I stoga s anđelima i sa svima svetima tebe hvalimo Eva in ci verso questa. Razdomi i dade učenicima svojim govoreći, uzmite i jedite od ovoga sve, ovo je moje tijelo koje će se za vas prati. Isto tako, pošto večereše uzimajući ponovno, zahvali i dade učenicima svojim govoreći, uzmite i vidite iz njega svi, ovo je kalež moje krvi novoga i vječnog saveza, koja će se proliti za vas i za sve ljude na otpuštanje grijeha. Ovo činite meni spomenu. Tajna vjera. Slaveći dakle spomen smrti i uskrsnuća Tvoga Sina, prinosimo Ti, Gospodine, kruh života i kalih spasenja i zahvaljujemo Ti što si nas pozvao da stojimo pred Tobom i Tebi služimo. Smijeno Te molimo da nas, pričasnike tijela i krvi Kristove, Duh Sveti sabere u jedno. Spomeni se, Gospodine, crkve svojim širom svijetu, usavršio ljubav zajedno s Papom i Franjom, biskupom našim Daglasom i sveukupnim svetljenstvom. Spomeni se i naše braće i sestare koji uskuše u nadi uskrsnuća i svi koji preminu šrtvom smilovanju privedi svijetu svoga lica. Molimo te, smiluj se svima nama, da zavijenimo biti sudionici vječnog života, s blaženom Bogorodicom Djevicom Marijom, s blaženim Josipom njezinim zaručnikom, s blaženim apostolima i svim svetima koji su živjeli u Tvojoj ljubavi, da Te hvalimo i slavimo for Jesus Christ, the Lord is here. O Cristo, Christum, meu Cristo, teve logo a sua morte, o início do respeito, sua carta de slava, o sveglie e a cola. Mi se zove to i jesna djeca Božja, za srpuni povzdanje molim, Oče naš, koji jesi na nebesima, sveti se ime Tvoje, dođi kraljevstvo Tvoje, budi volja Tvoja, kako na nebu, tako i na zemlji. Hleb naš svakdanji daj danas i odpusti nam duge naše, pa koji mi odpuštamo dužnicima našim, i ne uvedi nas u napast, nego izbavi nas od zla. Nauli Heus, kad smo glasni, pod vidom i nevije, pod ljubav i smiju. O God, who by your mighty power created all things out of nothing, and when you had set in place the beginnings of the universe, all men and women in your own image, making the woman an inseparable helpmate to the man, that they might no longer be two but one flesh, and know that what you are pleased to make one must never be divided. O God, who consecrated the bond of marriage by so great a mystery, that in the ready covenant you foreshadowed the sacrament of Christ and his church. O God, by whom woman is joined to man, and the companionship they had at the beginning is endowed with one blessing, not forfeited by original sin, nor washed away by the flood. Look now with favor on these your servants, joined together in marriage, who ask to be strengthened by your blessing. Send down on them the grace of the Holy Spirit, and pour your love into their hearts, that they may remain faithful in the marriage covenant. May the grace, O Lord, and peace abide in your daughter Marianne, and let her always follow the example of those holy women whose praises are sung in the scriptures. May your husband Peter trust his heart in her, so that acknowledging her as his equal and be joined here in the life of grace, he may show her true honor and cherish her always with the love that Christ has for the church. And now, Lord, we implore you, may these new servants hold fast to the faith and keep your commandments, may one in the flesh, may they be blameless in all they do. And with the strength that comes from the gospel, may there be a true witness to Christ before all. May they be blessed in children, and provide themselves spiritual parents who live to see their children shepherd. And grant them reaching at last together the fullness of years, for which they hope they may come to life of the blessed in the kingdom of heaven. We ask you this through Christ our Lord. Gospodine Isuse Hriste, ti si rekao svojim apostolima, mir vam ostavljam, mir vam svoj dar. Molimo, ne gledaj naše grijehe, nego vjeru svoje crkve, daruje mir i jedinstvo, kakve volje tvoje, koji živiš i kraljuješ u vijeke vjekova. Mir Gospodnji bio vas na svom.
Is there
E vogliamo sapere che voglio che tu io tu si magri e si appagoni con tu il supporto anima con il suo viaggio. Rospodine e venisse a costa e andami in supporto a noi, ne gustamo e se chiedi, oltre a ricevere tu usciamo. Chielo che storia. Mosè. Gospodine, porto smo se pripetili, molimo da ovi mladenci uvijek pristaju uzad i ljudima svjedoče o Tvojoj dobroti. Po Kristu, Gospodinu našem. The rest of you, please be seated now. Mary Ann Greener, best name, may you honor, you will come forward and sign the documents. And before the final blessing, I would like to thank all of you on behalf of Peter and Marianne for coming to church today and celebrating together in this holy Mass, this center of marriage, of the sacrament. And we have prayed for you. We have mentioned many times your name during the Mass, and I am asking you now to know this is all. Find a moment of peace, quiet, and say a prayer for these people who have come today. And for all of those who have been involved in the preparation of this day, and those who have come to you to become who you are. And to all of you, would you please see them? The Lord be with you. May God, the Eternal Father, keep you of one heart in love for one another, that the peace of Christ may dwell in you and abide always in your home. Amen. May you be blessed in your children, have solace in your friends, and enjoy true peace with everyone. Amen. May you be witnesses in the world to God's charity, so that the afflicted and needy who have known you kindness may one day receive you thankfully into the eternal dwelling of God. Amen. And may Almighty God bless you all, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace. Congratulations. On behalf of the Church, I pronounce you now as husband and wife.
Something.